2014, the world marks the 100th anniversary of the beginning of World War I. Why should we remember and think about those events that happened 100 years ago? I would like you all to take a deep breath, hold it, and slowly let it out. That breath of air you just took floats over a free and democratic Canada, forged by the men we are honoring today and by those who followed in World War II. That's why we remember them. By the end of World War I, there were very few people who remained unaffected. The war reached out and touched almost everyone's life in some way. We were not immune here in Fenelon Falls and neighboring communities. 57 of our men were killed in action. Parents lost sons, wives lost husbands, children lost their father, brothers and sisters lost a brother, and the fallen lost a life full of potential and promise. In addition to the tens of thousands that served and returned home, those who go to war at the request of their nation don't know the fate that awaits them. World War I was such an overwhelming mix of sound, fury, and unremitting horror. They went off to battle in the summer and were to be home by Christmas. Instead, the misery went on for years. World War I was described as a war to end all wars, and as history shows, it did not. Millions of men enlisted, sent to fight in foreign lands. It was a global struggle, and life was never the same again. The use of chemical weapons and mechanized warfare took killing to horrific heights. Today, we remember not only our local men, but the millions that were killed or wounded in one of the deadliest conflicts in human history. We remember the youth cut down in their prime as they fought in the trenches under the most vile conditions imaginable. The war resulted in terrible losses. Over 9 million soldiers died as a result of the fighting. Nearly 6 million civilians died from disease or starvation. Almost 1 million more were killed as a direct result of military operations. In all, the estimate of dead resulting from World War I is over 16 million. And then there were the wounded, more than 21 million. Some recovered, others were never the same again in mind or body. These young men of our community answered the call when needed and served with courage and valor. The majority of them were farmers under the age of 25. They sacrificed the comforts, love, and safety of home in order to defend the rights and freedoms of others. Some returned with permanent physical and emotional scars. 57 of them never returned. Veterans know the price of freedom. It's not measured in dollars and cents, but in the hard currency of life and limb. So many died so that you and I could grow old in peace. This was an extraordinary sacrifice of a generation. It was a sacrifice they made for us, and we have a debt and an obligation that we can only repay by remembering. We should be committed to ensuring that sacrifices and contributions of these men, and indeed all veterans, are never forgotten.